Hello, family. Hello, Poodle Pack. Hello to everybody that came in. Kendra and Crafty Caboose and Shelly and Ren and Shirley and Judith and who else? All of you. Tammy and Ms. Fiery Wood Sprite. Speaking of Sprite, I'm drinking Sprite. And Donna and Yvette. How's everybody doing? Can you guys see and hear me good? Everything's good? Hi, Leslie. Hi, Debbie. Hi, Mandy. Hello to everyone. Hello to everyone. What did I get on my sweater? No. I like this sweater. I'm pushing my sleeves up. I may have to take it off, but I'm a little chilly today. I don't know why. It was warm out today, and I'm still chilly. Awesome. Glad you can hear me. Hi, Jane. Hi, Ideas to Come. Hello. Hello, Bobby. If you're new here, stick around. We're going to work on some crafts. If you want to work along with me, what we're going to need today is you're going to need some small containers like this or like plastic cups. It doesn't have to be ramekins. I just happen to have a boatload of ramekins because I make a lot of creme brulee. And what I'm doing, I'm not worried about. I can wash it out. It's just, it's going to be a little bit of watercolor, or you can use food color, liquid watercolor, and it's glass. I'm not worried about it. I'll still use it to eat with. I don't care. I'm not using like acrylic paint or anything like that, but you can use acrylic paint if you don't have liquid watercolor or any kind of dye or food coloring or anything. You can even use Kool-Aid for this. Oh yeah, that's weird. Why is it doing that? I just noticed that too. Hold on. Let's remove that. No, hold on a minute. Let me see how I get rid of that. Oh, okay, yeah. Let me remove that. I made a boo-boo. There we go. Sorry, guys. My thing decided to just double. I don't know why. Very weird. So you're going to use containers, whether it's plastic cups or something glass or whatever. And you're going to need as many as you want colors. I have 6. And then, of course, you're going to need your different, if you have food coloring and you only have like 4 colors, you can mix like the red and the blue to make purple and this, that, and the other. So, yes, it's gone. I fixed it. So if you want to work along with me, you can. We're going to do some bubble art, which is a lot of fun. And you need some simple things. You just need some Dawn dishwashing liquid, or, you know, it doesn't have to be Dawn. Any dishwashing liquid that you have will work. I don't have any dishwashing liquid, so I'm using this, which I shouldn't be using because it's expensive, but it's a Castile soap, which is, you know, it'll give bubbles. So that's all that's important. I use it because it's organic, and I use it to make my paintbrush cleaner. I use it to make my own hand soaps and foaming soaps and stuff like that. So that's why I have it, but I'm running out of regular dish soap, so I can't use that. But you would use regular dish soap. That would be the best way to do it. And so, yeah, we're going to do that. I have, what, 6 bowls here? So is anybody going to work along with me and do this, or am I going to be the only one today? Oh, it is, Jane? Your spring card is made from that? Oh, that's funny. I didn't even realize that. I've never done this technique before. I've done a lot of different things. I've done the shaving cream thing, and I keep meaning to do a video or a live stream on that because I have all the stuff to do it, and I just, but I've never done this before. I've seen it done, but I've never done it. Oh, cool. Thank you, Raquel. I really appreciate it. I love those magazines. I had them as a kid, and I don't have them anymore, and I wish I did, because I just like reading them and reminiscing. Because when I was a kid, I was into all, you know, when I was a teenager, my first concert was Poison. So I was like a huge hair band, you know, girl. I was always hanging out with all my friends who were into hair bands and stuff. The 80s were the best. So Raquel said she was going to send me some vintage, you know, from the 80s rock magazines, which I think would be pretty cool. There was one I saw, she had a picture of them, and there was one underneath of a couple in the front, and it was Sebastian Bach. And I had that magazine. I had that magazine, and I kept it all the way up until probably right after my mom died, because my dad threw everything out and threw those out, and I was keeping that magazine. I had that one with him on the cover like that. So that's why I want it again, because I'm like, damn it, I love that one. All right. So all what you're gonna do is all you're gonna need to do is put some water into the bowls, and I guess the ratio, I mean, you can kind of eyeball it, but they were saying like 2 tablespoons of water for 2 tablespoons of the soap and then 2 tablespoons of the color. But I'm gonna kind of eyeball it and see what happens, because I don't really feel like doing the tablespoon thing. But I'm gonna do like a little bit of that, and I have to be careful because I only have like a little bit of soap, so I'm hoping that I'll have enough for this. But luckily, this soap is concentrated, so it shouldn't be an issue. But let's try the orange. Let's put some orange color in there, and then we'll give it a try. We'll wiggle it around, and where'd the straw go that I had? Well, I have another one here somewhere. There we go. Doesn't matter. And what I'll do is I'll have a test paper, and I'll do a test. Because what you're going to do is blow bubbles like that. And then, where's my test paper? There it is. I have shiny paper, but I'll use the matte side for now. And then you just put it over it. And, oh, look at that. See? And then the color's on there. I'm going to add a little bit more of the orange to this. Nice. There we go. Now it's nice and vibrant. Awesome. I was just blowing and adding the color as I blew into the straw or added the paper over it. But yeah, see, so that's what we're going for, these really cool patterns. Okay, so now that I've kind of figured out how I want it, you're just gonna eyeball it. I'm adding like a little bit of each. I did the orange already. Let's do the magenta. And we'll test this out. I'll use the other side of the paper, the other end of it. And a little bit more color needs to be in there. So that's what you're going to do. You're going to do each one and test it. And if the color comes out vibrant, then you're good to go. If it doesn't bubble up, then you need a little bit more soap. You know what I mean? Like just eyeball it until you get it where you want it. I'll let that dry a minute. Move on to the next one while that dries. Add some water to the middle one. A little bit more. And then some soap. And then some blue. And these are just Sargent Watercolor Magic. They're just liquid watercolor, cheapy. They're nothing expensive. They're cheapy brand. And you can get those on Amazon or pretty much anywhere. Cool. That looks good. I have to stick my finger in it. Now we will do turquoise. Drops of the turquoise in there. And if you're worried about your hands getting messy, you can wear gloves. I don't ever worry about that. You know how I am. I don't care. Don't care how messy my hands get. Then we got violet. Rinse this off in my bucket. Why does it look brown? Wow, that's weird. I'm gonna have to bring these closer to me. We need more color. Usually with purple, it's purples or violets, you need extra color because it's a more opaque pigment, I guess. That's better. Okay. And one more. Which one am I missing? Magenta, turquoise, violet, yellow. Yellow, that's the one. I have green too, but I don't have another bowl. Maybe I'll switch it out later and do green. Instead of one of the colors. Might take off my sweater because I don't want to get it messy. And I have a feeling I'm gonna get it messy. This is a messy job, but fun. Fun and messy at the same time. Okay, that's it. There's the yellow. Look how cool that looks already. Can't beat it. It looks awesome. All right, are we ready to play? Yes, give me a thumbs up. Thumbs up, people, thumbs up on the video. Right, good times are afoot. I don't know if feet are ever a good time, but if they are, they're afoot. All right, let's get some regular cardstock and let's start making some cool backgrounds, shall we? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to puff all of these up at once and then go like that and lay it down. I should probably start back here. Okay, that looks really cool. That looks good. Doesn't that look awesome? Let's do it again. Let's do it again. I want to do it the same way I just did it to add more color. My yellow is lacking a little bit. Come on, yellow. I've got a little bit extra soap in you and in you just to get you moving. Ah, I got some in here. Get out. Get out. Don't contaminate my yellow. Don't you contaminate it. No, you don't. Okay. Start back here. That looks cool. I just like seeing the bubbles all piled up. You can't see it from the side view like I can, but it looks really cool. Pretty. I just wanted to get all the colors at once. This yellow is giving me problems. There we go. They look pretty. Huh. Oh, it doesn't take that much to blow them up. You could stop and take breaks. Right, let's do some more. Let's do this color. I'm just adding a color, adding more and more color to it. Adding more color. Just go in and scoop out the little bubbles. That is looking cool. Add a little more magenta. I think I mentioned this before, but you can also use Kool-Aid. I've seen people using Kool-Aid online. And there is one completed sheet. I think that looks cool. And it could be cut up into ATCs. Here's this one kind of dry. You could see it really good what it's going to look like. The other one. Isn't that cool? I like all the purple, like the little bubbles in the purple. That's really cool. Really cool. So I figured we'll do this for a little while and then we'll find something else to do with these prints. Maybe we'll cut them into ATCs or something. So there's one. I want to use one of the glossy cardstocks and see how that one picks up the color. Who knows? I'll do one at a time to start off. And what's cool is you could do this and then Like, I'm trying to get it to go down or just go like that. I wonder if I... Now, it might not like the glossy cardstock, but it could give it a cool marbled effect, actually. That might have to dry a little bit longer, so I'll go on to a piece of cardstock and kind of let that dry and see what happens. We'll see what happens when that dries, because I think it'll actually look cool with different colors on that cardstock. We'll use regular. We'll do another piece of regular. Let's do that with the regular, like this. Oh, that's kind of cool. Doesn't give as much of a bubble pattern, but it gives a cool, I don't know, it gives a cool, some places it gives a bubble pattern, other places it's just like plain color, but I don't care, it's still cool looking. Experimenting. Oh, I'm sure, yeah, I've seen that you can use acrylics too, you just need to water it down, but because I'm using these ramekins and I just want to be able to clean them, this stuff is non-toxic and I figured I can clean them out real easily and reuse my ramekin, so that's why I didn't use acrylic paint, but you can. It's non-toxic kids watercolor. If you just leave it like that and let it sit, it gets really intense. Ooh, I like that. I like that a lot. So that's what we're gonna do. Gonna scoop and let it sit. You can also do this where you take it and you blow the bubble. It's not really blowing bubbles here, but it gives like a cool splat. Let me use a different color because you can't see it with the yellow as well. See how it gives a cool like splat? Let's do a different color. Let's do the pink. Oh, that's cool looking. This is fun. This is fun making a mess. I love it. The bubbles on the pink look hot pink when I blow it, when I blow them up. I'm just gonna let it sit like that and do its thing. This one's still got like bubbles, but it looks really cool. Look how cool that looks. Oh my goodness, I love it. I like letting the bubbles sit like this because then you get like some really cool patterns. Let's do one on here just to add an extra little oomph on here. We'll do it with the turquoise. Like that and let it sit. I've got a paper down, but it's completely saturated and soaking through. I better get another paper and lay it on top. Hold on a second. Gonna make a pretty piece of paper when I'm done. I don't care if it's crinkly. Craft mat on top of my desk, so it doesn't really matter. I just didn't want it to start leaking out and like onto me. Okay. Now we can go back to this one and try another one. We'll try it the traditional way. Alright, my mouse is acting like a jackass. I can't get it to scroll up the comments because I was trying to look. I don't know why my mouse is acting this way. I hate it. I need to get a new mouse on my other computer, on my main computer. I need a mouse desperately because mine's all screwed up and it doesn't click accurately, so I'm going to have to break down and buy a mouse probably in the next couple of days somehow. I have to use my YouTube money for it, unfortunately. And it's going to cost me $30 for that mouse because I can only... These kind of mice, I only use it on my laptop because I don't use my laptop much. But it's like a typical, you got to move it around. Very bad for my arthritis. I have to use the trackball mouse. It's the Logitech trackball. And it's got a ball that I just move my finger. I don't have to move my hand around too much. So I get that one and it works great, but... After, like, I've had that for, like, 8 years. And after about 8 years, it starts to not work right. So, it's a pain in the butt. Yeah, see, it doesn't do as many of the defined bubbles because it doesn't seep into the paper like with the other one, but it gives a more marbled look on the... This is glossy cardstock. So it gives like a really cool kind of marbled look, which I really like. Came out cool. That came out really cool over the like magenta color. It's hard to tell. My camera hates me. I mean, this camera is just awful at focusing. There we go. It looks really cool. I really dig the way it looks on the glossy paper a lot. The way it layers, it's just really cool looking. All right, I'm gonna let that dry a minute. We'll go back to this one. See how what that did? It gave like that really cool... Oh, that looks really cool. That's from getting the bubbles and scooping them up and letting them sit on the paper. That's really awesome. I like that a lot. I'm gonna do it again. Let them sit like that until the big bubble goes away. And I could do it here too. All right. Let's do some more on this little one. Do some more yellow. Move that over here. We'll get another piece. Interesting. Interesting. So who else is gonna, if they're not doing it now, who's gonna do it later or tomorrow or another day? Look how cool that one came out. That is so stinking cool. Oh my goodness. Y'all gonna try this now? You must try it. Come on, pop. I'm making more of a mess. Oh, you could pop it and it does fine. I want to add more color. Another glossy, because the glossy is a lot of fun. I pushed it onto this paper. Isn't that funny? That just looks cool like that. So cool. If on the glossy paper, if you put it on there and you let it sit for a second, but not enough for it to all go bleh, and then blow it off onto another page, you get the cool pattern because it can't soak into this paper like it can regular cardstock. So if you want to make a cool pattern, you got to get it on there and blow it off. Because then you get like these cool patterns. Like this. And then just go. And it actually gets too. Well, this one didn't work. I left it on too long. But it gets on to other. I put it on this page. I'm blowing it off. That one, I left it on too long. Let's do some orange over top of it, maybe. Or no, we'll do orange over here. Nope, that one didn't work. Why did the pink and the purple work and that one didn't? Maybe I didn't leave it long enough. Maybe that's the culprit. Maybe it needs to be left long enough to stain the paper. I don't know. Well, that's cool. Still gotta work out the kinks on that one. My theory is wrong. Either way, it still looks cool on this paper regardless. Still pretty badass. That needs to dry for a minute. Let's see. See, this is the shiny, the glossy paper, and I just think it looks really cool on the glossy paper. Ugh, I got it on my computer screen. Let me get a baby wipe. I'm a hot mess. Well, I got it all over the place, didn't I? Goodness. I don't want it on my computer screen. This is the downfall of having to have a computer by your desk, by your workspace. Anyway, we can move on to adding some more to this one. Let's add some more purple. I shared it with another page. Probably going to want to put several layers of paper underneath of your workspace because just one or two is not helping. I've got like a flood going on here. I'm flooding. I'm flooded. Let's see about putting these under here. Flooding. So, there, maybe that'll sop some of that up. Goodness. Messy. So you just want to take like an entire newspaper, unfold it, and put your stuff on top of it. But I'm going to have some pretty drop papers when I'm done, so I'm okay with that. Yeah, just like you said, the drop papers are going to be gorgeous. Yep, that is true. All right, let's add some into the corner here. We will add some blue. Scoop. I'm just going to scoop it and leave it sit there. This one's ready for some orange. Scoop. Leave that there. I think this one's done. I'm good with that one. All right. Add more to this one. Let's add some orange right there. Nope, that didn't work out. Come on, get over there. Huh. Second, I have no more room. I've run out of room. Yes, I've seen a lot of people are having grandkids and all that stuff. Congratulations to all you grandmas. Ended up with green even though I didn't put green out because I put the yellow over the blue and it made this real pretty green. I should give these the opportunity to dry or try my heat gun. Maybe that'll help a little bit. Popping all the bubbles. Very wet. Very, very wet. This one can go down there, and this one can go back here, and then we can start a new one. All right, let's start with pink. I'll do it this way again. Gives a little bit more of a subtle look. Pretty, pretty. Do you think it'll add extra oomph if I burp into the straw as I'm blowing it? Which I did. I totally did. I was like, I burped into the straw. It's gonna add extra oomph. All right, let's add some more pink. Over here. We'll let that sit for a minute. That's right, you guys in the UK call it washing up liquid. It's just dish soap here. Well then, what do you guys call body soap? Like the soap that you use in your shower to wash your body? Do you call that washing up liquid too, or do you call that body soap or body wash? Anybody that came in that I haven't said hi to, hello, welcome. We are making fun, pretty papers. Ass wash. Yes, it's ass wash. Ass wash. I can't say it. I can't speak. Help. This one's becoming my favorite. I think I just want to add some purple to it. I'm waiting for those to... patiently waiting for those little bubbles in the center to pop. Or maybe I'll just leave it yellow, orange, and pink, and I'll just add a little bit more color down here and stuff. I don't know. What do you think? Should I add purple, or should I just keep it yellow, orange, and pink? You tell me. And then I'll do another one with blue, turquoise, and purple. How's that? How do you like them apples? Burping adds texture. It does, especially when you're blowing into a straw. Oh, I gotta blot this because it's getting muddy over here. Blot, blot, blot. Let's blot that dry a little bit. Then we can add some more color. Because I want to add a little bit more over here. I want to get it... Well, you know what? Let me dry it with the heat gun. Then I can add and it'll give... Yeah, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. If I add wet over wet, it's not going to give me the bubble pattern. It's just going to become another wet blob. So But if I add it over the dry color, it should give me the pattern. I know the best way to do this is with either food coloring or the liquid watercolor, because the liquid watercolor and the food coloring are very translucent colors. So when you mix them with water, they're not going to be super opaque. So you get this really cool layering that I've got going on here, where you could see like all the different colors popping up through. That's the cool effect you can get with the watercolor, or probably the food coloring too, I would imagine. But especially with the watercolor, I really like that because it's really cool looking, like on this one too. You could see the purple next to the orange and the yellow. It's just really cool how you got like all those colors like that. So I definitely dig it. Now we're going to add some blue on top of the green and see what happens. Groovy. We'll do this one. And we'll let that sit. Actually, I want to put some pink over here. There we go. Now I'll let that sit. Now we'll add some more pink and yellow and orange to this one. Let that sit for a minute. And I'll get started on the blue one. Give this a second to dry. Hi, Christina. Yeah, the purple over the blues look really cool. Well, then you'd be good at this, Jane. Well, you said you already did this, so I guess you were good at it. All this time, all that blowing bubbles in your milk. And now you know what you could do with it. It did not go to waste, that talent. Put that up there for a minute. I think I'm done with this one. I think we're good. Put that there. Let's see. I'm going to add a little bit more to this one. I'm going to add a little pink right here, which didn't really show up too much. Maybe I'll do that and let it sit and let that be dark. Break time. I would imagine I'm going to have to spray them ultimately, I think. Maybe, well, on the, what do you call it? On the glossy cardstock, yes, I probably definitely have to, but on this it absorbs in, so I won't have to really use a fixative on it. I mean, if I'm gonna glue a whole bunch of stuff over it, I might, but if I'm just gonna cut them up into ATCs and use it and just add some elements to it, then I should be fine. But on the glossy cardstock, yes, because as soon as I put anything on that, it's gonna wipe it right off. Not wipe it, but you know what I mean. Like it'll. I'm trying to find one of the glossy cardstocks. What did I do with it? I moved it. Hold on, they're on the floor. See, like, because it's glossy, like the slightest bit of water is gonna wipe that off. See, like I wet my finger. Oh, maybe not. Look at that. Maybe not. It's not coming off. I thought it would because I've used other things that. Let me see. Let's get a wet paintbrush and test this. Let's see. It runs a little bit, yes, but not as much as I thought it would. So it actually would be fine. I mean, as long as you're not doing anything heavy duty with it, like soaking it in water for a period, you know what I mean? It'll be fine. So I guess you really don't have to because it's not coming off. I thought it was going to come off a lot more. That's still wet. A couple spots are still wet. But like where it's dry, it's not coming off. And I put water on it and it barely did anything. It only moved a little bit. That shocked me. I thought it was going to actually move on that more than anything. So I guess not. And like on here, for instance, let's do this spot with the wet brush. See? Wet brush. It's really not moving it because it's soaked into the paper. So, I mean, but if I saturated it with water, then yes, it would bleed. But surprisingly, they stay pretty well. I don't know if it's this watercolor or what. I don't know if it's the bubbles or the soap. I don't know what's keeping it in there better, but whatever is, hey, that works. This one came out really cool. Like where the yellow and the orange are. Didn't that come out cool? Those are badass. Badass. Tammy makes her boys craft. She forces them. There's a heart on this one. Where? Oh, you mean right here? Yeah, little heart. I'm letting it fizz out on its own because it'll leave a cool pattern. But I guess I can add something to this corner. Maybe we'll add some more yellow. I gotta get the my blue is contaminating my blue and my pink is contaminating my yellow. That's okay. Let's do this here and let that sit. Get some intense color. All right, now we can go back to this one. See how cool that came out? That's groovy. So you could do like some lighter backgrounds by pressing it onto the bubbles and then adding some darker spots like this by scooping up the bubbles. And I just got purple on my yellow and pink one by accident. I didn't mean to. I got a little purple on there. Get off. Get off. I'm just picking up bubbles. I can just push it in onto the bubbles. I'm gonna add that scoop right there. And then I'm gonna clean off my stupid computer again, which is covered in paint again. Paint everywhere. But hey, I got a pretty baby wipe out of it. It'll be even prettier if I wipe across the top of these things and soak up some of the paint. Or do this. Well, they need to be wiped off, right? For the sake of making a pretty baby wipe? Of course. Ah, there we go. Now we got some color. We're cooking. Add a little pink in there. There we go. Look at that. I see some flowers. Look at this background paper. This is looking cool. This is like an all-around, like you get a lot of different art out of this. You get pretty baby wipes, you get pretty drop papers. In fact, I'm gonna move these over so that I can get some color moving around. Like so. So that the you can saturate over here now. That looks cool. That looks really cool. I can't wait to cut that up. Yeah, the cheapy ones will curl up, I think, right? And the more expensive ones will burn or something like that. I don't know how. I forget what I said. It works now. I forget. I think it's the cheapy ones that melt a little better and the other ones just don't. Okay, let's see. We can add some more to this now. Get another of the shiny kind. Let's see what we can do with that. Do some more pink. And just let that sit. It takes longer to absorb into that paper. But we can also do some bubble splatters. Like that. Bubble splatters. On the shiny one. The shiny one, it's better to do that technique. Whoops, I got blue on it. That's okay. I'm gonna use blue anyway. Because if you put the bubbles on top of it, it kind of turns really cool looking, but it turns like marbled. Whereas that takes a while to dry, but looks cool. Look at how cool that is. It's completely soaked through on both sides. I almost want to open it up and kind of try to continue getting color in the center pieces of it. This is a whole, I'm getting a whole montage of papers done. I'm getting the papers I'm putting on the bubbles, the papers underneath the bubbles, and the papers I'm, and the paper I'm using to wipe up the bubbles, the ass wipes that I used to wipe up the bubbles. It's a good way to get a lot of different type of background styles and colored papers. So cool looking. Look at that one. That made a cool pattern. I could probably do some more on this side. We'll do some purple. Purple! I got a lot of purple over that one. What's cool is the thing is with the glossy paper is you can spread the bubbles thinner and get a bigger, more coverage because it doesn't seep in the way it does with the others. That's all I want to get on there. Goodness. I have to keep stopping because I've run out of room. But it's so much fun to do. I want to make lots and lots of them. What I might do is save these because there's still a lot of stuff in here. Even when I'm done, I can save them if I can find some sort of containers to put them in, which I'm not sure I have any containers. Oh, yes, I do. Ooh, I have the perfect containers, which actually I can use right from those containers the next time, so I don't have to use my ramekins. I should have done that to begin with. I have, like, these little containers with lids, so you can keep this because it's soapy water with, you know what I mean? Like, you can keep it, and you can come back to it and use it because it's not going to mold because it's got soap in it. So, feel free to make up a batch and then make them in little... I'll show you the containers I have. So you can see. I only have four, but I can find two other little containers to keep in. But these, I got these at the grocery store, I think, or dollar store, and they have a lid. They're by Glad. These will fit my stuff, and I can use it right from here too, next time. So that's what I'll do is put these in those containers so that I can hold on to it and not waste it. Yeah, I'm sure I could dye ribbons and stuff in it for sure. But it might make the ribbon, because it's so soapy, it might not dry right on the ribbon. I don't know. I don't know how it would dry on the ribbon with all the soap in it. I mean, these, at least these smell like peppermint, because that's the soap that I'm using, is this peppermint Castile soap. And the papers kind of smell pepperminty, but not a lot. Just they smell just slightly pepperminty, which is really kind of cool. All right, I'm going to dry this one a little bit because there's one area I want to add some color to. Do that to there. All right, we can probably add more to this one. Maybe not. Let me dab this a little bit. That one was running. Okay. The glossy cardstock takes the longest because you have to let it sit. I think that is done. I think that looks awesome. Let's see. Let's add a little bit more color around here. Let's add some pink. Fun. Yeah, bubbles with tea and coffee dye. You could definitely try. In fact, if I can find my container of coffee that I keep laying around, it might work. I don't know what I did with it. Hold on, let me find it. And don't worry, I put glycerin in it, so it's not going to mold. It's got a couple drops. It got some glycerin and a little bit of alcohol, so I don't know how well it'll hold up with the bubble solution or the soap, but you could try it. I just need to find it. Oh, there it is. See? I keep it right in here. And it's still good because it smells like alcohol coffee. I don't know how well this will bubble up, but we can try it. Let's give it a try. We'll do it in this. See, aren't you glad I'm around to try these things out? Put a little of that in. Put a little soap in. I'm not even going to put water in it because it's coffee, so it's already got water in it. Let's see if that's enough soap. I don't know. Not quite. The bubbles are popping too soon. I need a piece of paper. Come here, paper. Do as I say. Don't you disobey me. Okay. Doesn't look like it's going to be very potent, but if you lift it up and let the bubble sit, you do get, look, coffee stained bubble art. If I just do this, I don't know how much it's going to actually stain the paper. Yeah, it like barely does. But if you scoop it up and let it sit on there, you get a better result. Because there's not, it's not as pigmented as the food coloring or the, you know, whatever. I mean, I guess if you soaked it, you know, made like such a strong coffee batch that it was like highly, highly pigmented, then yeah. Now my papers have coffee on them. I don't want coffee on them. On my mat. I wanted to keep that without it. It's all your fault. Look what you made me do. I wanted just color on these. That's okay. I will live. But yes, it does work. Not as well because it doesn't hold the bubbles as well. Because I put a lot of soap in here and it still didn't hold the bubbles as well. So it doesn't hold the bubbles, like it's mostly staining the paper. You'd have to do a really, really high concentrate of coffee. And this is a pretty high concentrate of coffee, but I would say, like, soak it for overnight and overnight and overnight. With the coffee, however you soak your coffee. All right, how I make my coffee is I take coffee filters, like three of them, fill them with coffee, and then bunch it up and take a rubber band and tie it on the top to make like a giant tea bag of coffee. And then I just drop it in and let it soak in the water, in hot water, in like a thing of hot water, and let it soak. And I do that, I let it soak for a few hours. But I imagine if I were to let that soak for like 2 days, it would probably be a hell of a lot stronger. So then it would probably be better to use with the bubble thing because it would be a more concentrate. Or if you use something like Sanka, where you can just dissolve it in the thing, which I don't have instant coffee, or else I'd use that. But yeah, so yes, I guess you can use this. I'm going to just set this aside because I don't want to use it anymore right now. But yeah, I guess you could if you made it a little bit stronger. Glycerin? What about glycerin? What needs glycerin? You think glycerin will help hold the bubbles? Really? See, I was afraid glycerin would make the bubbles go away. So let's try that. I have glycerin right here. I've always got everything on hand. All right, let's try it in the pink since some of the pink is starting to. Let's put a squirt of glycerin in there and see if it'll hold the bubbles better. Because my pink is starting to get low, so I added it to it. Let's see. Let's test the theory. I don't really see much of a difference. Let me try it on a new piece of paper. What's it supposed to do? Let's try. Ah! Well, it scooted onto my craft mat. That's okay. What's the glycerin supposed to do? Because it's making everything foamy, I think. It's not really. Not really making the bubble stay anymore. Oh, they put that in kids' bubbles to make it not pop. I gotcha. I gotcha. Okay, well, maybe. All right, that's done. Let me move these now. We're gonna move them back here. I'm trying to get an even distribution of color on my thing. On my papers. I think what I'll do is I can stack them temporarily. Oh, this paper ripped. Dang it. Didn't want that to happen. I was gonna take it up and let it dry. And then get some new ones. Hold on. Let me go grab my clothesline so I can hang those really quick. Let me hang this up to let it dry. I have a makeshift clothesline in my room so that when I'm doing jelly prints or whatever, I can hang up my wet papers to dry so that they dry quicker, since I don't have room to put them anywhere. I'm going to get another couple of sheets. I'm still going to hang this to dry. Come on, get off of there. Okay, let me grab more paper to put down. Alrighty, look what we have here. Enough to... There we go. Pick that right up. Alright. Now what I'm going to do is... I'm just going to do like this, and as they get wet, I'll switch them out. It'll be easier. Sorry for the wait, folks. Putting them in different orders this time. Sorry for the wait. Whew. Had to get those papers, because what was happening was, if I were to keep letting those soak in and soak in and soak in, they were going to rip. And if they ripped, I would be pissed, because then they'd all start ripping as I pulled them up and unfolded them. So I figured I might as well do it now. And I wish you guys can see behind me how cool they look. They look tie-dyed. I love it. I love doing this just for those papers, because they're going to make some really cool collage pieces. With rubbers. believe me, I could find some things to do with some... I actually have condoms in my drawer in my bathroom. They're old, so I wouldn't use them for you know what. But I would use them for art if I could find something to use them with. This summer or spring, you know what I do want to do? Is I want to go outside and take a big piece of fabric and lay it down and do the whole thing where you fill the balloons with paint and then you pop them over it and it kind of just spreads the paint all over. I want to do something like that. But I probably would rather fill it with, instead of acrylic paint, with like something like this. Like a watercolor paint or something, because I think it would look cooler that way. Yes, that's me, Terry. Why you ask? She says, is this Pink Poodle Crafts? That would be me. Okay, so let's add some color back to... I think we're done with this one. Nah, I want to add more pink on this one. I'm never done. When am I ever done? So I should add a couple drops of glycerin to each one then. I forgot we were doing that. Duh. So add a little glycerin to that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one. And I'm going to add a little bit more soap to the pink and a little bit more water. Where's my water jug? Because I'm starting to run low on a couple of these. And I have a pipette, which will probably help. And then the purple, we can fill up the purple a little more and spill it. And the orange. I think we should make a green, don't you? I think so too. I'm gonna make a green. Because I have green, but I was like, oh, too much water. I have green, but I didn't use it because I didn't have enough containers. Well, guess what? I do now. And I want to add more. What's this? Magenta. And more violet. Add more blue. Is this blue? And we have to add the soap in here yet. Alright, let's try green. Let's see how. Yeah, that should be good. Oh, we need another drop cloth. Now I'm getting into territories where I need two drop cloths. All right. Maybe we'll stick this one there, or this one here, and this one like this, like that. There we go. Let's add some green to this one. That one's nice. Let's just do that and see what happens on that. Let's just do it. We'll just do it and do it and do it. And then you can add some color to this one. I think I'm done with this one. That one's done. Let's do another. Rubbers or boots? Yeah, not so much. I don't know if I mixed all these up yet when I added the glycerin. Did I add the glycerin to that? No, I don't think I add the glycerin to the green yet. Alright, let's do some more green. Alrighty. I might need more watercolor color in there. A little bit more. Actually, I want to do green. I'm going to add just a tad of blue because I want to make the color a little different. We're going to change the color from green to like a blue green. A green blue. Something like that. I don't like green as much as I like green with blue in it. Damn. Why don't you just get all over the place, why don't you? That's prettier. See, it went from more of like a grassy green like here into like a blue green here, which doesn't show up on camera, by the way. Blue greens are not a color that ever shows up properly on camera. But that just blew up all over the place. Messy. You're a messy green. Let's add a little more blue. Nope, that's the green. Where's the blue? I bet it'll turn really pretty. I'm just experimenting. Making my own colors. Probably easier if I mixed it with this. A little bit more blue. Not quite there yet. Might need a little more soap. This one's a full one now because I added so much to it. But I want like a green. Ooh, there it is. That's the color I want. It's not going to show up on camera, of course. But I wanted that color. That turquoisey green color. Not turquoise, but whatever it's called. Like an aqua color. You know what I mean? That's what I wanted. Got it. Let's see. Ooh, that is a nice color. It looks so blue on the camera, but it's actually like such a pretty green blue. It's really pretty. I'll take pictures later and the pictures will show it. I'll take pictures to show you the real color of that. The inks I'm using are actually watercolor. They're liquid watercolor. They're non-toxic liquid watercolor. Sargent Art. You can get these. You can get like the whole set of what, 10 of these for like less than $20, I think it was. $15, something like that. And they're a lot of fun to use. I make sprays with them. You can do all kinds of things with them. I'm digging it. All right, let me put that down and do another one. Do some on here. Yeah, I guess, I don't know whether it's the glycerin or the fact that I've got, it's filled up so much is why I'm making such a mess here. But I may have to get another piece of paper and help sop this up. Because it's really full. I probably should dump some of that out so it's not so full. What I'll do is I'll smush it. And then I'll flip it over like that. Alright, you stay there. You stay there. You stay there. And then I'll take another paper. I'll put it under here. There we go. Now I'm going to take the other one and I'm going to pour some of this in here because there's just too much in that little container. It was overflowing every time I did it, so we can hold on to that for later. That's for another time. But I really like this color. This color is like my favorite. I like the turquoise, but I like the blue-green color, the aqua color. I don't know what it's called. Got a lot of pigment in it, I'll tell you that, from all the pigment I put in it. Yeah, that's cool. Groovy. Loving it. Gotta put back the other colors. This one should be separated from others because it really bubbles up more and I don't want it to contaminate. Well, shit. I just dumped it on my lap. That was smart. Really smart. Luckily, my lap took the brunt of it. So did my keyboard that's sitting here. Hold on. I just got to make sure I didn't get it on my carpet. I dumped it right on my lap. Isn't that lovely? Hold on, people. Care if I dump it on my lap. That doesn't bother me at all. it's getting it on my rug. That would piss me off. I don't think I did. No, actually, I surprisingly got very little to no stuff on my rug. And mostly just on my lap and my cabinet. Splattered a little bit. Thank goodness for that. Luckily, these drop papers were sitting down here. Goodness! Messy! See what you made me do? See what you made me do? Okay, well, I think this page is almost completely saturated. So we're going to twist it over here. I'm going to soak some of that up, and then we're going to hang this one up to dry, because that was an easy way to make the papers wet with pigment and ink and whatever the hell this is. Let's hang this one up, shall we?
We shall.
Okay. Back at it again. Phew. We're making a mess. Definitely be aware that you will make a mess with this project. Yeah, they are washable watercolors, so even if I did get it on my carpet, they probably would wash right off. Anyway, let's try again. Maybe more carefully this time. I think so. That would be a good plan. The problem is I can't get the bubbles. This one needs to be barricaded in, unfortunately, because I don't trust that I'm not going to knock it over because it's so light compared to the other ones. I think I'm actually going to barricade it like this so I can't pull it forward and knock it onto my lap. You know how I am. I'd knock anything over. It'll all be worth it in the end when I have all the pretty papers. Don't you think? It'll be worth the fuss. Don't like it with the glycerin in, because then they don't pop when it hits the paper, which gives it that circle. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's not as good like that, in my opinion. It's better if they, you know, if it holds its bubble longer, then it doesn't work as well. I don't know why. Like, the purple, I put the glycerin in, and it's not giving me the circles like it did before. So I probably wouldn't put the glycerin in again. I really like that one, but it can use some pink. See, like it's not popping them, it's just pushing them. And it's getting a little harder to get them to do what I want them to do. Add more soap. Where'd my straw go? There it is. I think I'm gonna be done with that one. That one's done. Pink is still okay. Needs to dry, and that needs to dry. I run out of room so quickly when playing with my mess. Well, let me show you the ones I did so far, so you can see, besides the drop papers that are hanging up. Here's the first little test sheet we did. That one I love. That one came out really cool. Then we've got this one, which I did some of the bubble splattering on and all kinds of good stuff. And then we've got this one, which is where I was letting the bubbles, like the big clump of bubbles, sit on the paper, and it gives it that darker, kind of richer look. And then here's another one I did that with. But I just like all the variations. Like, you can't see it in the camera. It does not come through as well on the camera. But that area where there's green, it's got, like, bright green all the way down to yellow green and, like, all different greens in there. Same with, like, in here. It's, like, all purpley and blue, and but it doesn't pick up as well. Like, the camera does not do it justice. And then there's this one where I did the lighter background and then put some of the bubbles to sit on top of it to accent, like, make them bigger. And then there's this one, which I still have a little runny do here. It's okay. That one looks cool. And then there's this one. And then there's this one. So I actually want to add some more to this right here. I want to add some purple. Or do I want to add... No, I want to add pink. I will leave that over here to dry. And then we did this one, which was like a cleanup background, and then I added some stuff on top of that. So that's where we're at so far. That's what we got done so far. Plus the stuff behind me that's drying. This one here needs some turquoise on it, or whatever this color is, this green-blue color. This is teal. That's what it is. The other one's turquoise. This one's teal. Teal is more green, isn't it? And turquoise is a little bit more blue. I don't know. I don't know. Thank you. Trying to use my drop papers evenly, or as evenly as possible, and get some different colors in different areas. Actually, I want the orange there, and the teal there, and the pink there, and the yellow there. Okay. Let's do another glossy cardstock with purple. Did I just get it in my mouth? I think I did. Time for a new straw. How's that? How about a new straw? My straw, I think I got stuff. No. I don't, but I thought I had color on my mouth. Thankfully, it's non-toxic. So I could drink it. Yeah, I think what the glycerin does, it makes the bubbles too heavy, and instead of rising up, they all just overflow. So I think I do like it without the glycerin better, to be honest. Just my opinion. Because it goes over even more when I use the glycerin, it seems like. And the bubbles, yeah, they might stay, but I don't want them to stay. I kind of want them to bubble up and then pop as I push the paper onto them, and they're not doing that, really. That one's not too bad. That one stayed up pretty well. It's fun to play with these. Very fun to play with. Let's do some of the teal. And we'll scoop it up onto there. Are you guys bored yet? Look at my hands. They're like all different colors. They're like yellow and purple and green. Oh my. Mm-hmm. Very interesting. My lap is like yellow. Look at my shirt. That's the yellow that dumped out. That's all right. I'll survive. Make it drip. Very cool. Let's put some orange on here. Interesting. Take care of our papers. Very integral part of this is making sure I have pretty drop papers. So, it's very important we take care of our papers. Oh, thank you. Thank you for the $2. I appreciate it. That was really sweet of you. 70 Acre Studio. Which I can't remember your name again. Crap. But thank you so much. I appreciate that. Okay. Let's put some pink over here. Over there. I think maybe I put too much glycerin in is what I did. I probably should just put a couple of drops, and I think I squirted like a bunch in there. That could be the problem too. But it's still working fine. Cardstock. Hold on a second. I want to do a couple more before I give up and we move on to something else or whatever we do. Okay. Got some more cardstock. All I had was the glossy stuff, and I like to use this a little bit better. I like them both, but I wanted to do more of that. You have a troll in your house? I do too. He lives downstairs. I have a troll too. Luckily, he's not home tonight. He went out with his little friend. Or whatever. Went somewhere tonight. Let that dry a second. This one here needs to be tapped off. It's dripping. Put any of these. I have no room. Alright, you go up there. Okay. This one I can call pretty much done. I think I'm just gonna sop up anything on there that's getting kind of taking too long to dry. Let's stick that over there. And this one's still got bubbles going. I think that one's done too. Probably that one too. They're both done. Okay. Now I have room to put another one. What's going on? Who's doing what? Oh, you're going to buy the pack of ephemera? Awesome. Thank you. That's really cool. I'm up to where it says Angela said she liked my tie-dyed hands. Oh, yeah, your name is Melissa. That's right. I forget. I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm not good with names. When it comes to like a screen name not matching the name, I have issues sometimes. Well, thank you, Melissa. I really appreciate it. Add a little bit of water to the pink because it's acting a fool. Still acting a fool. Where's my little spoons at? Here they are. Let's take out some of this foam. That has accrued, whatever, on top of my pink. Ugh, I just splattered it onto the piece of paper that was sitting on my lap. And a little bit onto my lap. Good Lord, I'm a hot mess. Here. Anywho, let's try the pink now. That's better. Now it's staying up instead of sopping to the bottom of the thing. It's kind of staying put. Pretty. Oh, so pretty. I think I'm just going to leave this one pink and purple. Let's throw a little more pink on this sucker. Awesome, that's done. All pink and purple, unicorn. The unicorn colors. Let's get this sucker down. The soap suds won't even go down. It's like pure soap. All right, well, there we go. It was all soapy. Yep, my lovely tie-dyed hands. Oh yeah. Nice and pepperminty. I smell good. Well, this one's all jacked up now, so we might as well keep jacking it up. Let's do it this way. Oh, that one on that one. I didn't want it on that one. Goodness. That was supposed to be just pink and orange. Never mind. Jackass. Stay on there. Do as I say. Get up there. Ugh, it's gonna take some drips now. This is going to be the drippy paper, apparently. No, they're not pure watercolor. They've got a little water in them and some soap. Okay. Goodness, I'm making a mess. All right, this one's done. I want to get it out of here before I end up getting that contaminated too. I need to get some of that color out because it's turning brown. Goodness, mess, mess, mess. I'm gonna have to change all my clothes. Have I gotten it in my hair yet? I'll be walking around with tie-dyed hair. Alright, let's see how this drop paper's doing. Let's put that one there. Put this one there and that one there. As far as that goes, it's actually pretty Yeah, that one's pretty saturated. Is this one completely saturated? No, it is not. So we can take this and move some of these over. And hang this one up. Or just flip it over like this. Because it's still got some good spots there. Strategic. Gotta be strategic with these papers so that they get all the good juice. Gotta get all the good juice. Oh, who gave $10? Thank you. Oh, Jane. Thank you, Jane. That was really sweet of you. This one actually looks kind of cool. It's got some groovy colors in there. Groovy colors. Is that all the paper? Hey, no more paper? That's not fair. Dang it. Well, I think I did enough anyway. I've got a lot. Now what I'm going to do is help my paper. We're going to help the paper saturate with color and get pretty. Doesn't that sound like a plan? We're going to mix some teal in there. We're going to let it soak in. Mix some blue. Mix some pink with that. Get it purpley goodness. Let it all sop into the paper. We'll do some yellow over here. Now we're just dyeing the paper. That's it. We're just dyeing paper. I don't know where to put it. Let's put it there. Yummy. Let it soak on through. Purposeful disasters. Cool and goats? What the hell are you talking about? Who's cool and goats? What does that mean? What does that even mean? That's more fun than doing the bubbles. Sitting here planning out my drop papers. I have to let them sit so they can soak through. Isn't that pretty though? That looks pretty. I want to paint like this. I think I'm gonna do that. I think one day I'm gonna get some watercolor paper and just saturate the crap out of it with different colors like this because that looks cool. Chickens are cool? What are you talking about? Goats and chickens? Oh, you're talking about goats and chickens. Never mind. You guys are weird. Anybody that's new, welcome to the live stream. You have just come at the time when I am making a mess. It's a good mess, though. It's a fun mess. I am making purposeful drop papers. I figure, why not? Then when I dry them, they'll be ready to go. As soon as I take them off, after they're dry, I can just use them for collage and such. Yeah, it's a creative mess. It's a creative masterpiece of a mess. I'm hoping to go tomorrow, but I'm not sure because Chris went out with his friends, which means that he is not going to get in until really late, which means he's gonna not gonna get up in the morning, which is going to cause me to be pissed because then we won't be able to go. I'm just sopping up what's here because I think that's pretty well soaked through. Another beautiful wipey. All right, let's take this one and, ooh, yeah, that went through. And see if I can't hang that up without killing myself. I do need some more thingamajiggities. Oh man, I hope that's dry because I want to take this down and show it to you. Yeah, it is. Awesome. I need to show you that paper after I get this one hung up. You guys gotta see it. So awesome. See if I could do this without ripping it because. Oh. Hold on, where's my pipette? Let's add some more color. Awesome. All right. Wow, that's really pretty. Holy crap. Let me try to do it from this side because it might not rip. I don't know. This might rip. This is scary. Oh boy. Oh boy. It's hard to pin this up. These tiny little clothespins are impossible to get open. Ah, crap. All right, this has got to just hang over like that. Ugh, too wet to not do that with. All right, anyway, look at this one. The colors aren't showing up as vibrant as they are because of the white balance. If I drop the brightness down here a little bit, it'll help. It'll make it show. Come on, my mouse is acting like a jackass. Come on. Jesus. All right. Seriously, mouse? Come on. There we go. Work. Issues. Come on. Point. somewhere. Oh my god, it takes forever. All right, anyway, now you can see how darker, much more darker the colors are. But anyway, that is more accurate. Nice and yummy. Isn't that gorgeous? Holy moly, I love it. I love it, I love it. So that's one there. Now I've got to pick up, let's see if the other one's dry enough to pull down. Yeah, it's good. Then I can get the other one up there. Okay. And we've got this one, which looks really badass. Badass. And now we're going to take this one and we're going to add some more color to it right over here. Why not? We don't have enough yellow. Fun to dye your own papers. Good enough. That's groovy. These are going to drip on my carpet. I'm going to put something down. I'll put these other papers down just in case. Try to drip at all. They should drip on the paper. Okay, because they were kind of saturated. One more. We're just going to throw this one up. I don't care what it looks like. Because, yep. Okay, and then here's one of the first ones. This one ripped in the middle, but that's okay because it's good for collage. That one's real pretty. Okay. All right, friends. Oh my goodness, what a mess. What a mess. Leave this mess. My hands are so sticky from the glue, the soap. What a mess, what a mighty fine mess. Yes, it is, yes, it is, yes, it is. My poor ramekins. I make really good creme brulee. Really, really good. Like restaurant style. It took me a long time to perfect it. And I love making it. And like holidays, I usually make a whole like 12 ramekins of creme brulee for people that would come over and have dinner at my house. Because I would always host. That was nice. I just spilled more as I was trying to clean it. Good job. Good job. Thank you. At least I'll have some nice baby wipes. Colorful, cheery baby wipes. I'm just cleaning the outsides of them. Whew, that's a lot of mess. But worth it. Absolutely worth it for the awesomeness that I got out of this. Where's the other cap? Oh, shoot. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Okay, let me go find a cap for that before I spill it, because you know I will. The other one too. Goodness. Okay. Pretties. This one still's got a couple of wet spots on it. But overall, they are dry and they look awesome. I hope you guys are going to give this a try and just post your pictures up on the group. And if you don't know what group I'm talking about, then you should get informed and know what group I'm talking about, because it's important. We do important work there. We call the White House and tell them, hey, stop everything until after the live stream, right? Right, Shirley? Right, everybody that saw that post? That was funny. That was funny. Hi, Steve Jobs from Mexico. Are you resurrected from the dead and you faked your death and went to Mexico? Post a recipe? I don't really know the recipe. You just kind of got to eyeball it. Same amount of soap as you put in water, and then just add your pigment to your taste, you know what I mean? To your liking, whatever. I mean, I'll put it up, but I mean, it's really kind of self-explanatory. Just play around until you get what you want. That's the biggest tip on that I can give you, because that's the first time I ever used it. But I'll definitely put up something. I'll put up what I did, kind of. But you got to play with it yourself, because it might be more pigment for you. Who knows? It could be more, you know, more soap works or more water works. Soap, water, and glycerin, but only put like a drop or two of glycerin, because otherwise the bubbles are too heavy and they don't puff up enough and they kind of fall down. So you want them to puff up, and you also want them to break when they touch the paper. So if they're too much glycerin, they get too heavy and they fall over, and then not just that, they don't pop and they don't make the pretty pattern. So you'd only want to put like, I guess the ratio would be like two drops. You know, two, three drops max of the glycerin. I was squirting a whole bunch in there, so don't do that. Just put like three drops maximum of the glycerin, so that it's just enough to help it, but not hurt it. In that case, less is more. I always like to say more is more, but in that case, less is more. Yeah, be careful with the lube. Well, that's what glycerin is. It's like, it's almost like, you know, like a lube. But yeah, but I really like how these came out. They're all really cool. This one's still got a big wet spot on it. It's still got a bunch of little bubbles right there, all bubbled up, which this thing will not focus on. And I'll just tap it. Make it move. Move, bitch. Get out the way. There we go. That'll make a good pattern. Oh, there's some more on here. All right. I think we're going to end the live stream here just because my hands feel so sticky and my lap is so sticky because I spilt it literally right by my private part and I'm soaking wet and I want to change my pants. I want to change my pants. So, so I had fun. I definitely had fun. I hope you guys try it and post pictures in the group if you did. exactly. Yeah, so, but yeah, I've got some, I'm going to take pictures of all my drop papers so you can see how cool they look. I'm going to give them a little time to dry, and then I'm going to take some pictures of them because, man, did they come out cool. I hope you guys had fun. I had a good time. It was something new and fun to do today. So, but I will post the recipe for the bubbles online on the group page. So, have a good night, everyone. I hope you enjoy the rest of your weekend. And hopefully, where's my mouse again? Good Lord. Hopefully, I can get to the flea market tomorrow. And who knows, I might find something there that I absolutely have to have that's under $10. Because I only have about $10 that I could spare. You can't even spare that, really. But I do want to go at least walk around. That was my main goal. So, I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for hanging out. Poodle Pack out.